petitions before God, and you may have some things that you need answered, some things that you prayed about that you're expecting an answer from. Well, today I want to let you know that the Lord says it shall be done. The word of the Lord says this: what things you ask when you pray, believe it. If you abide in the Lord, then you can
receive it, and it shall be done unto you.
Just keep the faith, have patience, just wait, and the Lord will.
Yeah.
Hello, family and friends. My name is Phyllis Dukes Harvin. I am a 12-year breast cancer survivor. Thanks to the Lord that I'm still alive.
My name is Mary Howard, and I'm an 11-year breast cancer survivor.
My name is Adrienne G. I have been a survivor for 20 years.
Barbie Dixon, and I am an 11-year breast cancer survivor.
Standing here from my mother, Dorothy Briggs. She had cancer in her left breast. In 2014, she had her breast removed. She had 9 years cancer-free. And we just thank God for her.
Joyce Abel, 18-year survivor.
My name is Carol Rimberg. I'm a 31-year first-time cancer survivor. I have recently been diagnosed again in the last 2 months. But I thank the Lord for what He is doing for me. And I know that He will continue to lead me and bless me and lead me in His way.
Thank you so much. We are blessed, amen, and it is good to see some of our cancer survivors here with us today. Thank God for you. Thank God for God's blessings upon your lives. Good morning, family. Good morning, family. Good morning, family. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. As we celebrate our breast cancer survivors, as we celebrate Brother Leo Richardson this morning, and we are grateful for this fifth Sunday services as Brother Sam will come and bring us a word, amen, and we are mighty, mighty grateful for God's blessings upon all of us, and it is good to be in God's house, amen, it is good to be able to tell God thank you one more time for your grace. And your mercy and your love for Dr. Etheridge and Sister Gwen, for Reverend Feditra this morning, all of the pastors and ministers that are in the building this morning, we say thank you, God. We will now turn these services over into the hands of Sister Joy Clark.
Good morning, family. Let me first start by saying I did get the memo on pink. It's in my glasses because the dress attire fell apart at the last minute. But yet God is still good and I am still here. This morning's program is dedicated to Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And we, as Reverend Stafford has stated, we are so proud and so blessed to have our many survivors in our congregation among us and in our church family. The program will go this morning as follows. Honoring our seniors, Dr. Leo Richardson. The morning prayer will be by Carol Rembert. Scripture reading by Sister Joyce Abel. A wonderful selection by our world-renowned musicians. Morning message by Brother Sam Myers, and I'm sure he will feed our soul well. Invitation to Christian discipleship, Reverend Geneva Stafford, and the benediction also by Reverend Geneva Stafford. Please govern yourselves accordingly.
The purpose, as adopted by one of the local church for seniors by their congregation, states to continue to engage our senior adults in the covenant community as they age by ministering the gospel of Jesus Christ, both to them and with them, and by facilitating connections with church and community resources. How profound! We give thanks for our seniors. You matter to us, and we know that we matter to you. And so, it warms our heart today to honor one of our seniors, Dr. Leo Richardson. Dr. Richardson was born in 1932 in Gresham, South Carolina, and attended elementary and high school in Laura, South Carolina. He played football and basketball at Morris College in Sumter, South Carolina, before graduating and earning a bachelor's degree in biology in 1954. Dr. Richardson then coached football and basketball at A.L. Corbett High School in Wagner, South Carolina, where he also taught mathematics, biology, science, health, and physical education. He also earned a master's degree from the Tuskegee Institute, now known as Tuskegee University, in 1961, and a PhD from State University of New York at Buffalo, New York, in Educational Administration, Organization, and Policy. Dr. Richardson served as the head football coach at Savannah State from 1964 to 1968. He was assistant professor of biology and head basketball coach at Savannah State University from 1964 to 1971. Dr. Richardson led the Savannah State basketball team to a Southern Intercollegiate Athletic Conference tournament title in 1970, for which he was named Coach of the Year. He was assistant professor of health and physical education and head basketball coach with the University at Buffalo from 1973 to 1978. He was the University of Buffalo's first African-American head basketball coach. Dr. Richardson was also elected to the Savannah State University Sports Hall of Fame in 2010. Dr. Richardson's other accomplishments include former assistant to Commissioner for the South Carolina Department of Social Services, lay members of the South Carolina Board of Pharmacy for 21 years, executive director for the South Carolina Institute on Poverty and Deprivation, former Vice President of Morris College Board of Trustees, Claflin University Board of Visitors, and Penn Center Board of Directors. He served on the Admissions Committee for the University of South Carolina School of Medicine during the fall of 2014, and as President of the South Carolina Low-Income Housing Coalition Board of Directors. He is currently serving on the Columbia Rotary Club Scholarship Committee and is a member of the South Carolina Athletic Hall of Fame Board of Directors. He is also a retired United States Army veteran. Dr. Richardson was married to the late Mary Jane Fryson Richardson. He is the father of three, Sandra, Alfred, and Mary, and he is also a grandfather. Francis Burns, please join us in celebrating and honoring our senior for today, Dr. Leo Richardson.
Thank you.
Good morning, Francis Burns. Having a little problem here just getting the tissue out, so I'll just go ahead on. Today, we celebrate and honor our women who share their ups and downs of breast cancer, but continue to serve the Lord, and we thank them each and every day. We thank you. Let us always remember where prayers go up, blessings come down. Our women who shared their story today are of strong character. They are of great wisdom. They have multiple skills and compassion. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you for all that you have done for them and also for us. You have given us strength, and grant that we may always take that strength and serve you. Wherever you lead us, we will always enter knowing that you will walk with us and be with us through these difficult times. Though I have just been diagnosed again with cancer in the last several months, I trust in the Lord, and I will continue to trust him until I die. The Lord has a plan for me, and I will follow that plan, whatever it is. Now, though there are persons who have gone to be with the Lord already, you know that they are with the Lord. The Lord loves them. The Lord loves us. May we continue to walk in his way, in the way you will have us to go. We know that there are a lot of difficulties in this world today. We know that there are a lot of things going on. But we know that God, who sent his son to die for us, is still here. He created us. He created me. He created all of the persons who were on the stand today. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we know that in this day and time, children have problems in school, but we know that you are there. Although it seems that you are not there, you created us, and this is your world, and we love you. Be with all of them. Be with our leaders. Be with Reverend Stafford. Continue to give her courage, because she has so much to handle. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for all that you have done. And we continue to thank you day by day. Lord, as I take this journey, I thank you because I know that you are Lord of my life. And for all those who have gone with you, they are with you through many trials and difficulty, but they suffer no more. Lord,
Thank you, Jesus. I give you thanks. I give you thanks for all the persons that are in the congregation today. Grant they may continue to know that you are Lord, and you are Lord of our life. And anything that happens during these days and times, you are God. And all we need to do is trust in you. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, Francis Burns. I shall read the scripture to you all this morning. Psalm 119, verses 137 through 144. I will read from the New International Version. You are righteous, Lord, and your laws are right. The statutes you have laid down are righteous. They are fully trustworthy. My zeal wears me out, for my enemies ignore your words. Your promises have been thoroughly tested, and your servant loves them. Though I am lowly and despised, I do not forget your precepts. Your righteousness is everlasting, and your law is true. Trouble and distress have come upon me, but your commands give me delight. Your statutes are always righteous. Give me understanding that I may live. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Thank you.
that's what I'm talking about. That's what we're talking about. Let's give them another round, please. See, that's the way you want to get started. And, I say to you this morning, Francis Burns, good morning.
Good morning.
No, we're better than that. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right. See, now we're going to have a good time here today. And we've got some things we're going to share with you. Won't be with you long, but we do have to talk to you for a minute. You know, when Reverend Stafford called me, it must have been Wednesday evening or Thursday night, she said, I need to talk to you for a minute. It was a short minute because she said, I need you to do something for the church. I said, what is that? And she said, well, a speaker for Sunday is not going to be available. And I said, I'll do it. I didn't even have to go into that. But you know, it's a thing about being ready. You always have to have something in front of you and something that can help you as you continue to move forward. And I always try to make sure that I have those cues and clues together so that I can do that. And I just want to thank you, Reverend Stafford, for just reaching out to me and giving me this opportunity. I want to just thank God for giving me the opportunity to be able to stand here today, because without him in my life, there would be no Sam. Join me in a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this moment. We thank you for all you've allowed us to do this day. We've got survivors, and we've got some who've gone on to you, dear Lord. Breast cancer awareness is every day, and we just want to thank you so much for this opportunity. We just ask you to bless us all as we hear the words and use those words as they're coming through, and just touch our minds and our hearts and give us the opportunity to do that this day. And we thank you always. Amen. Our thought for today, be ready so you don't have to get ready. Be ready so you don't have to get ready. And you know, when I was talking to Reverend Stafford in the office this morning, she said something about something that she was doing and talking to some folks, and she said, be ready. She didn't even know that was, she was leading right into what we're going to talk about today. You know, a few weeks ago, I delivered the morning prayer, and as a part of that prayer, I mentioned that we experience hurricanes all the time. We know that a hurricane is a violent storm with violent winds, and all of them have different names, some being Ian, Katrina, Hugo, along with the various degrees of wind speeds and resulting damages. Some of us begin early making preparations for what is coming. Some of us put it off. And some of us will say, I'll ride it out. Without a doubt, you know some of those people. And you don't have to look around to see if they're there. It could be someone in your family who said, I'll ride this out, because it's not going to be as bad as we think. Raise your hands if you made a New Year's resolution. Raise your hands. Now, see, some of you are looking at me like, why is he going to get me to tell a big fib this morning? You talked about a resolution, and some of you are still resolute 10 months later. Hadn't even looked at it. But that's okay. You did do something. You walk every day. So I'm going to give you an opportunity right now to exercise. So I just want you to find someone that you're going to wave to, and just wave to that person, okay? Just wave to someone. Now, that's your exercise for today, all right? If anybody asks you later on today, did you get some exercise today? I sure did. And then you won't have to make up anything. You know, the late, great Muhammad Ali said that a champion is not made in the ring. Rather, a champion is made outside of the ring with the preparation that he or she makes to become a champion. Be ready so you don't have to get ready. You know, I serve many times at different track meets as a starter, and I use that blank gun, not a real pistol. Okay, this is a blank. And I see one of those little track stars right there, and she probably can contest and confirm that she's only waiting on the bang. You know, the bang is the thing that gets you started. But in order to get to it, you have to have done something to show what you've done. What kind of preparations have you made? The bang can go off all day, but if you don't come out on time, you're going to be struggling to catch up. Be ready so you don't have to get ready. Track stars, football players, teachers, principals, custodians, you name it, they all have to be ready for the different kinds of things that are coming their way. We all experience those hurricanes, and we never know when one will enter our lives. Some of them have different names like cancer, as we've talked about this morning, bankruptcy, loss of a loved one, and accident, all of which come with different degrees of pain, tension, frustration, and the list goes on. Hear the words of Matthew 25, 6 through 13. And at midnight, a cry was heard, "Behold, the bridegroom is coming. Go out to meet him." Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise answered, saying, "No, lest there should not be enough for us and you. But go rather to those who sell and buy for yourselves." And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding, and the door was shut. Afterwards, the other virgins came also, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he answered and said, "Assuredly, I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour in which the Son of Man is coming. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour in which the Son of Man is coming." Listen to this ready moment, to this be ready moment. I grew up on a farm and enjoyed every moment of it. My grandma would say, "There's a storm coming. Close up those chickens, get the cows in, and put those buckets and small things away and get inside." Yes, we are children. We heard the rumbling of what sounded like thunder, but just like children, didn't think anything big was coming. For some reason, we were not given any tasks that would take us away from the house. She kept us close. But once inside, she would say, "Cover all of the mirrors and everybody find a seat and no talking because the Lord is working." I'll say that again. No talking because the Lord is working. Now, we already knew something was wrong with that because you know just like I do, you don't go in that living room and sit on that couch that's covered in plastic or anything else. You know it. Come on now. And we knew something was going on because when she said, "Go inside in the living room and sit down," we all had to think, boy, somebody's in trouble. But still, she said, "The Lord is working." And just as she had discerned, there was massive lightning strikes, very loud thunder, heavy rains, and there was no meteorologist, no one who called her, nothing she saw on TV, nothing from the radio, just good old-fashioned wisdom that she knew of something was coming, and she had to get us to a point where we were protected. You see, my grandmother had many talents that helped her to have lived a wonderful life and be ready when those hurricanes appeared. Just as she used the talents God provided her, we have to do the same. Some notable talents are being hospitable, being tolerable, being relatable, being a comforter, being a singer, being musicians. Now, some of you think that you might be able to sing, shower time or wherever. You can sound like Whitney Houston or whomever, but once you get out, you're not gonna do it. I know I'm not a singer, but I do have some other talents that I use to the best of my ability, and I don't wanna squander those talents. But just having talents are just things that you're skilled in. You know the parable of the talents in Matthew 25, 14 through 21, where two of the three servants were good stewards and used the talents given to them, and they profited. And also there was one who did not use those talents the way that he was supposed to. Let's reflect for a moment on preparing for the hurricanes of life. You see, in verse 21, it says, his Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things, and I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. Remember those people I said that would have put things off? I'll ride it out. Well, verse 30 says, and cast the unprofitable servant into the outer darkness. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth if you're not good stewards of the talents that you're given. A good friend passed away a couple of weeks ago, and some of you may have known Mr. Frank Williams Jr. He was co-owner and funeral director of Williams Funeral Home in Sumter. His final message was, when I stand before God at the end of my life, I would hope that I would not have a single bit of talent left, and I could say, I used everything you gave me. I would say, I used everything you gave me. Francis Burns, my question to you is, what talents has God given you, and are you using your talents? And at this stage, you should never have to wonder what they are. Do you know what your talents are? Now, I could probably play that Jeopardy music and give you 30 seconds to think about that, but it shouldn't take you 30 seconds to think about what your talents are. You should know what they are. You should be using them all the time. Once again, be ready so you don't have to get ready. As I close, I leave you with this. I just want it to be said to me by the Lord, well done, well done, well done. Amen.
Be ready. Thank you. So we don't have to get ready. Amen. Thank you so much, Brother Sam, for a wonderful word. Amen. Yes, we want to be ready because we won't have time to get ready. Amen. Glory to God. We are grateful for this day that God has given to us, and we are thankful for all of you that are here today. We say that there may be someone that don't know Jesus for the pardon of their sins. You may be sitting among us. You may be on Facebook, on YouTube, or on the telephone. But wherever you are, you can cry out to God. And if you ask God, the word declares that he will come. Says he stands at the door and he knocks, and if anyone would open up, he'll come in and sup with them and allow them to sup with him. And so today, wherever you may be, we invite you to come to the Lord. The Bible says he's faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Is there one today? Wherever you are, just lift up holy hands unto the Lord. Ask God to come into your heart. God will. Maybe somebody that does not have a church home or does have a church home, but you've decided to make Francis Burns your church home, we invite you to call our church office at 803-754-1760. You will be connected to Crystal, who will connect you to the pastor and other leaders of our church, and we will welcome you, not so much into Francis Burns, but into the fold of God, that you will be a kingdom worker, a kingdom builder. Then today as we pray, we want to pray for Brother DeAndre Brabham, who had surgery, who's in the hospital, in Lexington Hospital at this time. We ask that you pray much for him this morning. Pray for Sister Marietta Steed. We're happy to report that after being in life changes for months, she's going home on November 1st, and she wants you to know thank you for all of your prayers and your love and your concern. Amen. So we're grateful. We're grateful for that this morning. Pray for Reverend Pearson, for Brother Willie Reinhardt, for Sister Gertrude Bryant. Pray for all that are on our sick and shut-in list this morning. Want to continue to pray for Sister Carol Rembert and her bravery, amen, as the Lord continues to bless her. Let us pray. Gracious and everlasting God, Lord, we come now before your presence, thanking you for another day, thanking you that the blood is still yet running warm in our veins, thanking you for our souls still having another glorious chance to worship and to praise you. Lord, you've been good to us, God, and we come one more time just to lift up holy hands unto you, knowing that you are our God and we are your children. Lord, we ask now that you look down upon each of us, Lord, that you strengthen us, God, and you hold us like only you can. God, we continue to pray for this world, God. We continue to pray for the men and women in Ukraine, God, for those in Russia, God, for those in these United States of America. God, we pray for our president and our vice president, God, for Congress and House of Representatives, God, for Senate right now, God. We pray as we vote next week, God, we pray that you will be with us, God, that you will get in our hearts and our minds, God. Continue to use us for your glory, to allow our voices to be heard. God, we pray that you move like only you can, because we know that you are God and beside you there is no other. God, we ask that you continue to use us, for we are your children and you are our God. We pray now for every doctor, for every nurse, for every staff worker in hospitals and in nursing homes, God. We pray for EMT workers right now, Lord. We pray for those that are confined to hospitals and in their own homes. We pray, God, that you would move like only you can. Then, God, we pray for every principal, for every teacher, every bus driver, every cook, every custodian, every counselor, every librarian, God's in schools everywhere. God, we pray for superintendents and administrators right now. We pray that you continue to move, God, because we know that our schools are in a state, but we know if we ask it in your name, you said it shall be done unto us. So, Lord, we come one more time asking you to look down upon our babies and our children, our youth and our college students. Look down upon professors and deans and those in foreign land right now. Look down upon those that are homeless, those that are hungry, those that are behind prison walls right now. We pray that you would be with all of us. Touch our bishop and our district superintendents, our cabinet right now, Lord. Continue to use all of us for your glory. And Lord, we'll be ever so careful to lift up holy hands unto you, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. It is in the mighty and sweet name of Jesus that we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Good morning, church family. I'm here on Fifth Sunday, as I said I would be. God has allowed me to be here and allowed all of us to be here this Sunday. On the first Sunday, I came to you and asked and noted first that this month of October is Pastor Appreciation Month. And I asked all of you to please bring cards and that we would have a basket decorated. And that is sitting here and that is ready now to be presented to our pastor, Reverend Geneva Stafford. And first off, I'd like to recognize any other members of the SPPRC. Would you please stand? And in particular, I'd like to thank Ms. Wanda Beatty and Ms. Gladys Gilliard McBride for decorating the basket. But Pastor, just know that we, as members of the SPPRC, as well as members of this whole entire church family, we appreciate everything that you do. And please, and this is just a small token of our appreciation. So we thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Francis Burns family. Amen. Let's give yourselves a hand. Amen. Thank you. Brother Leo Richardson, we have honored you today. Amen. Would you come and say something to us?
What happened to my glasses? Got them on. I thought you'd like that. I thought you'd like that. I was trying to find some words to say thank you so much for this recognition. I would like for my two daughters to please stand. Sandra on the right and my baby on the left, Beverly. Thank you. My son had some health issues in Atlanta. And my granddaughter had to be with him there. So they'll be all right. Reverend Stafford, I want to thank you and the members of the congregation for this opportunity to say something to you. But first, let me recognize two young men that I recognize, and maybe others. Young man who played football for me, who lives in Charlotte. He and his wife are here. Mr. Billy McDowell. Mrs. McDowell, would you please stand? Played football. Thank you, Billy. We had the pleasure of sort of winning a championship in football while we were there. And I think you saw the picture. Billy, you missed your picture up there, beginning of services. Have another young man who whom I got out of the playground in Wilmington, North Carolina, working in a factory, said, boy, come and go with me to University at Buffalo. So he came, led the nation in rebounding, played overseas and Globetrotters, and ended up playing 5 years with the Atlanta Hawks from Wilmington, North Carolina. He's here with us today. Sam Pellant, please stand. He's 6'9", 6'8", 6'9", so he got my attention immediately. At that size, he wasn't as heavy as he is now. Living large now. So we're delighted to have them. Also have a cousin here. Would you please stand, Vaughn Moore, who was... my fraternity brothers, who came to be with us today, would you please stand and be recognized? Thank you, sir. Alpha Phi Alpha fraternity, just in case you didn't know. I have so many others of you who are here because of this day, and I want to thank you for coming. I see my tax lady sitting in the front of the room with us, Mrs. Thompson, E&J Tax Services. So she said, you aren't going to invite me to your services. Please come. So thank you so much, Mrs. Thompson, for being with us. You saw the pictures on the wall there. I'm like Sam Myers, who was raised on a farm, sharecropper's son. I'd like to know that my son, who's an electrical engineer, went off to school, came back, and puzzled on his face. He said, Daddy, you slept in the bed before your brothers and sisters outhouse pump in the backyard. I said, yeah, certainly did. Had a mule when I was 7 years old, plowed him and all that. And to have the opportunity that I had you heard what the lady said. May have some Morris College people here. I'm not sure if you're here, but if you're any Morris College people here, will you stand? I'm not sure if they are any. Thank you so much. Thank you. I say that because when those things were read about my background, I had no idea after flunking all the entrance exams at Morris. When I first got there, failed all of them, every one they gave me, all the tests. And I remember just like it was yesterday. Mr. Richardson, you have failed all these tests, and you have to come to summer school to make up for it. And so I'm on the football team. So I left his office and walked outside the door, and I cried. But I said, Leo, you're not responsible today, but you are henceforth. So 4 years later, I'm on the honor roll, president of junior senior classes. All-conference football player, and had 6 jobs that I had never had to apply for when I graduated. And all the things that you heard there, the opportunities I've had, I got them by telephone calls, never applied for any of them. And to stand up here and not have tears in my eyes, and the Lord's been good. I can't thank you enough. Lord's been good. Thank you so much.
Amen. Thank you so much, Brother Richardson. He will be 90 years old next month. Amen. And we are grateful. Please be reminded that today the children will go to the matinee. We ask that you all be there at 12:45 at the American Theater on Harbison. Please make sure that you are there by 12:45, not our time, but please, 12:45. Because the movie begins at 1 o'clock. The movie begins at 1 o'clock. Please be reminded to bring money for your snacks. Y'all know how we are. So please, parents, please have your children there at 12:45 so that everything can be taken care of. It's a wonderful movie for our young people, and so we are grateful to God for Brother Brandon and his team and all their hard work, and so we thank you so much for that as they go out today and watch the movie. Please bring money for snacks, okay? Please bring money for snacks. Please bring money for snacks. Parents, don't act like you forget, all right? Also, today is Fifth Sunday, where we always donate to our mission ministry, and so they are asking you to please donate to mission ministry. They are wanting to help families, helping families. They wanted to do the Thanksgiving baskets as well as help those in need at the Hannah House and the Children's Garden, so please be reminded of that. Also, the United Women in Faith pecan sale ends today. Please see Sister Rebecca. I know she's here. Wave your hand, Sister Rebecca. She's all the way in the back. Please see Sister Rebecca if you want to order. They will be downstairs, amen. So please make sure you turn in your orders before you leave today. Thank you so much. Now, we know that a lot of you have already voted. We know that there's so many of us that have not voted. We know that the polls are open and you can vote early. But on November 8th, if you don't get there before November 8th, you get there on November 8th. That's very important, amen? Please, please, everyone, please. Please, please, please go out and vote. Please go out and vote. And if for some reason you don't have a ride to the voting polls, please call the church office. Please call the church office if you do not have a ride to the polls. We will get you there. Please, please make sure that you do that. This is very important. This election is very important, and God will blow on anything we put our mind to, and we make sure that we do our part. Amen? So we want to make sure that everyone votes, all right? Everyone's vote counts. That's important. Everyone's vote counts. Please don't stay home and say, oh, they won't miss me. Please, everyone's vote counts. So please make sure that you get ready to go out to the polls. Thank you again so much for that. On next Sunday, we will celebrate All Saints Day. It is held on the first Sunday in November in our churches, and we're going to have members of the families that have lost their loved ones to come up on next Sunday morning. So please be reminded of that. Please make sure that you are here so that we will take a moment to just take some time to just say thank you to our fallen members, those that we love, but we don't see anymore. So please make sure that you come out on next Sunday morning. Want to say this is our Frances Burns member. She is the state epidemiologist, and if you can see this, she was on the cover of the Amira magazine, amen? And so we are grateful to God's blessings for the Dr. Linda Bell, amen? Again, we want to thank these wonderful musicians this morning. Thank you so much. To Sister Joy for being our worship leader, to Sister Carol for reading praying, and to Sister Joyce for reading scripture this morning, for those wonderful people working in the sound booth, Carrie and Stan, and for Adrian that's working on Facebook Live, to these wonderful ushers and greeters. Thank you. Thank you so much. If you are a guest, would you please stand? If you are guests today, please stand. Amen. We want to say thank you so much for coming to be in service with us today, and we pray that you've enjoyed the service today. And anytime that you are in the area, come back and be in service with us. We are so glad that you came to be with us this day. Amen. Amen. I'm sorry, Brother Leo. Amen. Thank you, Reverend, for being here with us. Amen. God blessings to you. You may be seated. As we get ready to leave this morning, we want to ask you to please be ushered out by the ushers. Please be ushered out by the ushers. They will come and lead you out. Please be reminded of that. We're going to ask everyone to stand as we bring this service to a close. Let us open our hands. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your blessings and your goodness and your mercy. And now, Lord, as we're about to leave this place, we thank you for the angels that will watch over us as we travel up the dangerous highways. And God, we thank you for one by the name of Brother Sam Myers, Lord. Thank you for blessing him and to allow him to bless us on this day. We give you praise and we give you honor. Now unto him who's able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceedingly great joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Let the people of God say amen, amen, and amen. Have a good week, everyone.